This is our BabyPlast liquid silicon rubber injection moulding machine. Perth's the guy that's been working on all this stuff with me for the last 12 months or so.
Yeah, about so.
We've chosen it specifically for us to make these little tiny seals and any other seal that we can fit into this footprint. This machine basically allows us to do end-to-end industrial IoT all in-house here at Element Engineering in Malaga, Western Australia. We've been pretty aggressive with the way we're trying to do things in-house. It means we've got full control over the design, but it also means that we've got feedback to the design. The reason why we chose this machine in particular was that these are quite small seals and we're only doing one impression in each mould, which is quite unique. For these seals to be made in volume by a supplier primarily in China, they would probably be wanting to mould 50 to 100 of them at a time. Problem with that is the complexity of the mould dramatically increases, probably 10 or 100 times, and their cost is very large as well for the size of the mould. A liquid silicon rubber mould with 50 cavities could be in the vicinity of $30,000. Then you've got the minimum order quantity for a production run. That could be in the vicinity of 100,000 pieces. Each one of these pieces might only be a few cents, but the dollars add up pretty quickly. So given that we're doing sort of low volume, high value devices, we can be switching the mold or the mold inserts out regularly, and we can be creating all the different seals that we want to create without having a $30,000 mold every single time. It's going to allow us to get to market and we'll address the need for higher volume as we go along. The value of the machine itself is equivalent to one production run of the seals we need to make a Cranio Pro. So it's a no-brainer for us to bring this machine in-house. We'll learn a lot from this and push towards plastic injection moulding in the future as well, either partnered with a local company or bringing it fully in-house. We'll see what happens. Perth's the guy in-house who has helped to put it all together and get it commissioned. He's been getting everything ready, all of our bits on our side, and they've been getting their bits on their side to basically bring it all together. Perth can take you through it.
I've worked with the consulting technician Zoltan installing this for the past few weeks. So far, so good. We have the feeder, which essentially feeds the liquid silicon into our BabyPlast machine. What we have here are two 20 kilogram pails of our specified requirements for our Cranio seals, part A and part B.
You can have different mixes effectively that give you a different outcome. So this one here is a clear one because we want to get LED light through the seal. There's other ones which have different hardness. So this is a 40.
Draw 68.
So this is, you know, kind of on the harder side of a soft seal. The button in particular will have the same hardness as this, but we'll tint it with a different colour. And there's a colour and tinting piece there. But you can get different ones for oil resistance. You can get different ones specifically for, you know, ozone resistance or...
Yeah, UV resistant as well.
Yeah, ones that are used for medical. So this is actually a medical liquid silicon rubber, that sort of stuff.
It's mixed internally in this section of the machine and pretty much gets pumped through the nozzle and into the mould after it's clamped. You've got the controls, the touchscreen here, which controls all the movements that we will need to do in order to inject. It's a thermoset plastic. The molds actually need to be heated compared to a thermoplastic. So we've got these heating elements here for both the bottom half and the top half of the mold. And then also in the middle, we've got a thermocouple, which measures the temperature. So we get accurate temperature readings in order to set our liquid silicon.
We manufactured these mold bases from scratch because there's no mold base small enough.
No, not at all.
We actually have the inserts the wrong way.
So right now you can see the core part of the mold there, and then you've got the actual cavity part mounted on the top side. Instead of having this way, it should be the other way. The part that's coming off is stuck onto the top side, a bit of a hassle to get out, whereas if we have it at the bottom with the use of injector pins as well, will be a much smoother process.
Yeah, all the stuff we're learning, but we put this together in a very big rush. We're learning on the fly, which is good. These seals in particular are going to go into our first Cranio Pro devices, which are going to go out to field to test in trials in the next couple months. We haven't made a program yet. It's kind of miraculous that they've come out with such high quality. Some of them have got bubbles and not fully set yet. We'll finalize a program for this machine so that we can have consistent output. If there's any changes that we wanted to make, Perth can run the machine, see what changes need to be made, make the changes in CAD, go see the machinist Antonio, queue up some new molds. We're looking forward to making a couple hundred of these and getting ready for the first production runs of Cranio Pro IO devices. This is the top hat, we call it, control and compute module for the Cranio Pro. It has a number of different connections to the internet. It's got Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, cellular, GPS and long-range RF. It's got some RGB LEDs, and then we've got a button for the input of the device. So someone can push the button to turn the whole stack of cranio on, and then we can use feedback from the RGB LEDs to give us information. We're also going to have a button which will come through and allow the person to have a user interface. And then there's going to be another seal for a barometric or air quality sensor that comes out of this as well. So these seals are really important so we can create a rugged connection. This machine effectively allows us to create low volumes of the Cranio Pro product completely end to end in our own workshop. We will be CNC machining the housings, the different hardware that allows the stacking, and then these top hats. They're only tens of minutes on the CNC machine. We're even going to the extent of anodizing our own CNC machine aluminium for the housings. That's what Perth's working on next door. We can show you that another time. We'll make the seals on here. We'll get the circuit boards in from China. We pick and place them on the pick and place line. We'll assemble them in-house, QA test them and certify them, and basically package them up and send them off to customers. We're pretty excited about doing manufacture right locally and doing it really well.